Hey guys, so I just got my last light bill and again, it ain't pretty. For yet another month, it's high. One of the first things I like to look at on my light bill is the energy trend section. That's this graph right here. It shows you how much energy you've used over the past 12 months. And as you can see, some months it goes down and some months it goes up. The slot marked current shows you what your energy usage is for that particular billing month. And this is very useful because it can help you to figure out if something is off. Now, if these bars on the graph all look about the same height, and then suddenly you see a major spike one month, that's telling you that your energy consumption has gone up, could be dramatically, and that would explain why your light bill is suddenly very high. There may be something in your house that you need to check. Maybe the rubber on your fridge door is no longer good. I know from experience that can drive your light bill very high. Maybe some high energy appliance like an iron was left plugged in for a long period of time. Or maybe somebody is stealing electricity from you. All things that you need to check out. Now, if these bars are fairly consistent, though they're all about the same height, then that means you're using right around the same amount of electricity each month. If that happens and your light bill has still gone up, that's when you need to start examining other parts of your bill that we've discussed previously, like the foreign exchange adjustment, for example. Now, here are some tips that can help you to get your energy usage down. That's what we all want, right? So adjust your day-to-day behavior. Energy conservation can be as simple as turning off your lights or your appliances when you don't need them. When you're not using your appliances like your microwave or your phone charger, plug them out. Get into the habit of checking all your appliances before you leave home or the office. Ensure that everything's plugged out and all the lights are off so that you don't burn energy that you're simply not using. Use natural resources. I know we're all tempted to turn on the AC or turn on the light in the daytime when you're in a dark room, but you could also just open up your windows and let the natural light and fresh air in. Another thing you can do is invest in power saving equipment. I know that the last thing that you want to hear is spend more money, right? We're all about getting more money. But hear me out, there are energy efficient tools that can help you out in the long run, such as LED light bulbs. My light bill literally came down by 30% after we changed out all our bulbs. They're a bit pricey, so we did them, you know, a little bit at a time. Every month we bought one or two LED bulbs until the whole house was done, but I can tell you it was definitely worth it in the end. Fridge timers are also a great investment. It acts like a clock by switching between activating the cooling cycle and the defrost heater to maintain the set thermostat temperature. And this keeps your fridge from being too warm or too cold. And that's something that burns extra electricity. You can find these items in most hardware stores and even some supermarkets carry them as well. Don't peek in the oven. Every time you peek, you open that oven door, the temperature can drop 25 degrees Fahrenheit, making your oven use more energy to bring the temperature back up. And if you have an electric stove, there goes your light bill. And gotta admit, I'm guilty of this one, leaving the water heater on. When you're ready to take a shower, turn on your water heater for 10 to 15 minutes, then be sure to turn it off. Water heating is a major contributor to your total energy consumption. So I hope these tips have proved helpful to your household and your office spaces. Stay tuned. Taking Stock resumes now.